Hi guys, it's Danny. Today we're going to be repotting a Phalaenopsis orchid into inorganic media. But this time, I'm going to be using a classic clear pot that has, of course, extra ventilation holes, very similar to what I used until now. So here is my orchid. This is actually the Phalaenopsis I purchased last year, and as you can see, it's not looking the greatest. This media is done for. So I'm going to be using Hydrogen, of course Ceramis, and a clear plastic pot that I customized with some extra ventilation holes. And you have a tutorial on how to make them in the description. So let's pull out the orchid from the medium, and this is actually pretty easy because this orchid barely has any roots left. The medium is pretty broken down. This is one of the main reasons I want to switch to inorganic media. I really don't like broken down media every 2 years. So now it's just a matter of cleaning the roots. And when I say cleaning, I mean cutting all the dead roots. If you ever see a root that just pulls out, leaving behind a string, that's dead. You are free to cut it. So I'm just gonna go ahead and cut everything that I find mushy, papery, everything that doesn't have any substance to it. I'm gonna feel every root, and if I feel it's mushy, then I'm gonna cut it. There's really no point to keeping them, and when you're using inorganic medium, it's better to cut everything that's dead, because you don't want it to decompose inside the new medium and spoil it again after a few years. You want to keep your orchid as much as possible into the inorganic medium. Now, sometimes you might find yellowing leaves at the bottom. This is kind of normal for Phalaenopsis orchids. They regularly shed the bottom leaves as they grow new ones from the top. So if it's just one or two leaves, you're pretty much okay. It's supposed to be like that. If you ever see a yellow leaf at the top, then that's a problem. And now I'm just rinsing my orchid under the faucet just to clean the roots. It is important to clean the dead roots, but also every bit of organic material you find on them, again to prolong the life of your orchid inside the inorganic medium. So just like for a normal repotting, I'm gonna put a layer of medium on the bottom, and after I have a few layers, I'll position my orchid inside and try to arrange it properly so it's at the proper height and also it's centered. And then just place medium around it as I go. One more thing I'd like to mention, I used more Hydrogen because I'm using a plastic pot, which is totally different from a ceramic pot. And after 2 weeks since I actually repotted this orchid, I can tell you the plastic pot keeps medium much more moist than the ceramic one. There is a huge difference between this orchid and other orchids when it comes to drying. And to finish, I'm just making sure that the orchid is not buried inside the medium. I try to keep all of the leaf joints on top. And here is the finished product. As you can see, I have more Hydrogen than Ceramis, and still this orchid does not dry very, very fast. I think I water it once a week, which is kind of normal, so I'm pretty okay. So alrighty guys, thank you for watching. I will also pot a Phalaenopsis into a ceramic pot, just to see what the difference is. So if you'd like to see more orchid videos from me and stay up to date, simply subscribe to my channel. I post on a daily basis. Feel free to leave me comments, suggestions, or questions you might have in the comment section below. I always respond. Also, I have an address, so you can send me a letter or a package anytime you like, and you have the address in the description below. If you click on the left side of your screen, you're gonna be directed to orchidnature.com, where you'll find care sheets, identification sheets, and also you can talk to us in the forum section. And on the right side of your screen, you can click to watch another orchid video. Thank you for joining. I'll see you all next time. Bye!